possibly could, for like a year of $20. And I won't throw numbers at you, it gets a little complicated, but when that's said and done, we can put the orbiter on top. But I cannot, still can't agree with the fuel load because of the weight. That's why we stopped here, time for the bus, just a few minutes.
We're seeing the plan essentially as over a month, factory before.
This is how they come right out of the factory, yeah. All the flight controls are exposed, all solid original ducting, everything's here.
This one was a passenger aircraft?
This one came from 1979, NASA picked it up, and it came from American Airlines.
And how old was the airplane itself?
This airplane was built in 1970, I believe. 1970, you're thinking of the person ran so much, yeah.
It's older than a space shuttle.
Yeah. We're an ass. Yeah, it is older than that. They bought the airplanes first for the ALT program with Enterprise, the lifting body process. They had to do that to prove the shuttles could actually fly. So they used this airplane for that test. The test by some of the pictures hanging on the wall. That's why I knew it was space. It's a little bit lighter than the other shuttles.
How do you feel about how you can in flying space shuttles out in space?
It's hard because it becomes part of you. You live the job, and it's a dream job. You talk to the crew, you talk to the guys, people line up, and you flip the job. Sorry for the job, sorry guys.
your last flight, I take it, will be out to LA?
September 20th. It's in pencil right now. We're looking at flying to LAX with Endeavor, and I would strongly suggest you all go out to watch that. It's going to be quite the show. It's going to be where they're going. They have to cross the freeway on a four-lane bridge, and they're going to go down 10 miles down to the heart of LA to get to the site. So, with an 80-foot wingspan, they're taking down trees, light standards, and stop signs all the way. You want to be there for that.
How hard will it be to make that last flight?
Don't know yet. It's going to be just normal routine for us. We'll come down here, load up, and fly back like we always do. Nothing changes as far as configurations with the airplanes. But they said we're looking for 10,000 people, I think, at Dulles. And I have no idea what the award's going to be. It is. Anybody else around, do you? No, I'm high. Yeah, they're pretty touched. I mean, they're all the guys, we don't want to die. We like what we do, and we can do this another 30 years if we could. They're not able to do it, so we just deal with it day by day. Probably, yeah. It's going to be tough. But we'll make it happen.
Should fly on the
SCA
or on
Pathfinder? Well, that was the plan. However, by contract, I have to have maintenance people on board to watch the airplane and fly. But at this point, I don't know if I'm going to be able to because of politics. Very, very high people have been told that we're not allowed to fly on the airplane, so I don't know if I'm able to get on board this truck. We're still waiting to see what happens.
You got a shot from the other.
Depending on what we're doing, where we're going, a lot of times I'll have another two or three pilots on board just so they can get some seat time to stay proficient. We try to fly once a month to keep the guys current, and then they do simulator training as well on top of that. But normally, we fly, I've always got an extra flight engineer, which if you met Larry, and I'm sure Larry and Henry downstairs. Yes. Henry's my guru. He's, anything happens on this airplane, I go through Henry to make sure he's happy with it. Because if he's not happy, I don't fly. That's the rule. And he pretty much likes that, so if he's happy, I'm happy. Okay. We talk every day, almost every day about the flight, especially prepping for something like this.
So a typical ferry flight from, say, back from Edwards or something, there would be...
I could have six pilots on board. I could have all six pilots on board at one time and all three flight engineers, which we've got.
Plus additional.
Because everybody wants a little seat time with the shuttle all the time. That's a big thing. However, this time, because of the priority and the history making event, if you will, they're going up. We've got one, my primary crew, Jeff Moultrie and Bill Rickey, will be the two pilots flying legs between here and there. This trip, I don't know yet. I'm going to try. Let's see if they kick me off or not. So play it by ear. Sure, my pleasure. Yes, sir.
When will the to New York one
for the Enterprise?
When?
Right now, the plan has us leaving here the 17th. I'll be in Dulles for a week, and I think the 23rd we fly to New York. We'll be landing at JFK on the 23rd. Right now. That's provided everything gets fixed and everything gets prepped and we have no pitches in the get along. There's already a crew up there setting up the wind restraint system. We don't have an MDD like we have here. Okay, the offload. So what they're going to use is they're going to take two cranes and we have what they call a wind restraint system. We actually drill the apron and set posts with cable tie downs and come along and attach to the shuttle and maintain it so it doesn't move, keep it stable. We lift it off the airplane, they push the airplane out, we set it on the ground. Now this wind restraint system takes a week and a half to set up. So they're already at Dulles waiting for us to show up there. Now when we get offloaded from with Discovery, we get off Discovery offloaded, I understand they're gonna push back, I'm gonna get the airplane out of the way, and then we're gonna have a little nose-to-nose ceremony and parades and marching bands, and it's going to be quite the fiasco. Yeah, I'll be on the airplane higher, so it's all good. So after that, we're going to take Enterprise, we're going to load it up, and then we're going to fly to Dulles. JFK. Now when I get to JFK, I'm going to park probably 3 weeks while they tear down the wind restraint system and bring it up to New York and set it all up there. That's the only way we can do it.
I'm sorry.
Mary, can you come over here and ask that question? Because I want him to answer this way
before she gets out real quick. Just, how do you describe to family or whatever the difference between flying this versus a typical passenger jet?
There's no comparison. I can get up and walk around the stewardess and never yell at me if I had a stewardess. But it's great. We just come and go. I go up on the flight deck and play. It's the freedom of motion. It's when you're on a commercial airliner, you're a prisoner. Get out of your seat, you get yelled at, get back to your seat. Loud on this one. It's kind of nice.
I understand it's quite loud to, if you were to walk back here during flight.
Which we do.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's very loud.
Oh, it's very loud, very cold. Yeah.
Cold, too.
That's why we have the blue tarp hanging to keep the warm air up front. It gets about 50 degrees back here. It gets about 100 degrees. It gets cold.
Richard, again, could you go through the process from putting the opener on in detail, taking it off, what exactly you're going to be doing?
Oh, for this whole trip?
This whole process, yes.
Okay, in a nutshell, we're here to pick up Discovery. We'll probably start loading Discovery here on Friday afternoon, Saturday morning, the way it's going. Then we're going to push back for half a day and let you folks come out and have a field day, I believe, on Monday. Tuesday morning at 0:30, as soon as the sun breaks the sun surface, we're out of here.
We just want to know the science behind it, more of the detail.
The science.
It's like just, you know, you said you talked about pushing back, putting it on.
Okay, yeah. So at Dulles and JFK, they don't have MDDs, they make DMATE facilities, so we use a wind restraint system. They drill the concrete, they set pogos in the ground, and use cable tie-down system, and we lift with two cranes simultaneously. With the big yellow sling you see in there, we're going to use that sling and pick the orbiter up with that. So we'll get to Dulles, and they're already set up. They were there 2 weeks ago, prepping for all of us when we get there. So we'll pull in, we'll lift off Discovery, and we're going to push back for a day, day and a half, and let them do their ceremonies and everything. Then they're going to bring Enterprise out, and we're going to load it the same way, this reverse process. We'll bring it in, they'll pick it up, and I'll pull the airplane underneath and set it back down on top. We leave about a week after we get there, and we'll go to JFK. When we get to JFK, I have to wait, because now they have to tear down this restraint system and truck it up to JFK and reassemble it. And it's going to take a week and a half or so to do that. So we'll be up there about 3 weeks maybe, and then we'll offload it. Now we take Enterprise off, we're going to set it on the gear, and we're going to tow it over to the barge. We're going to have two barges set up. The first barge, it already has the balls and pedestals you see us putting on today. We took them off the other airplane, off the 9/11. We shipped them back, and they set those on a barge, because if they left the shuttle on its landing gear, it'd be too tall to get underneath two drawbridges they have to get. So they have a crane sitting on a barge next to the barge that's going to move it. They're going to pick it up, set it on the balls and pedestals on this barge, and they're going to tow it around and have another crane waiting to pick it up and set it on the U.S. Intrepid, as far as I know.
Now, is weather going to be a factor with it?
Absolutely.
Talk about the weather, how it's
going to
be a factor.
If it rains, we're not working. That's simple. Winds get too high, we won't do anything. I think we're allowed, I'm going to guess, maximum 10 knots. I may be wrong. I'm not the lift coordinator. I'm staying all out of that. I'll just take care of the airplane and let the guys worry about getting it on and off. The weather conditions can be a very big factor. If it's raining or too windy again, or lightning, we won't do anything. We'll sit away.
Are you concerned about that?
No, it's looking pretty good actually right now.
In terms of winds, like how what are what speeds that would not be conducive for this?
Probably 15 to 20 knots, absolute maximum. Anything over that, things start moving too much and creates damage or something breaks, we'll shut down.
Good? Perfect. All right, let's drop that one.